ओके थैंक यू। सो इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फोर्स मेजरमेंट इन दैट बैलेंस एंड स्केल प्रूविंग रिंग हाइड्रोलिक लोड सेल एंड न्यूमेटिक लोड सेल इज देयर। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी आर कवर्ड बैलेंस एंड स्केल प्रूविंग रिंग फोर्स मेजरमेंट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द हाइड्रोलिक लोड सेल देन न्यूमेटिक लोड सेल्स। ओके सो दिस इज द डायग्राम ऑफ हाइड्रोलिक लोड सेल। I request all of you to draw this diagram within 5 minutes. All of you, please draw this diagram within 5 minutes. Give the heading hydraulic load cell and draw this diagram. Hydraulic load cell. This is the force measurement instrument. Give the heading hydraulic load cell and draw this diagram. See the construction of hydraulic loads in here. Open container is there, in that fluid is present. Here loading platform means diaphragm over the fluid, and this fluid is connected to the with the help of pressure gauge. When you apply force on this diaphragm, this fluid get compressed and here increase the pressure, and this compressed pressure display in the pressure gauge. Means force is directly proportional to the creating pressure in the fluid. Okay, see the description. When a force is applied on a liquid medium contained diaphragm, the pressure of liquid increases. This increase in pressure of the liquid is proportional to the applied force. Hence, a measure of increase in pressure of the liquid become a measure of applied force when it's calibrated. Means when you applied force on this diaphragm get compressed, and this diaphragm get decreases, and this compressed fluid display here for pressure. Means force is directly proportional to pressure. The force is to be measured is applied to the piston. The applied force moves the piston downward and deflects the diaphragm, and this deflection of diaphragm increases the pressure of the liquid medium. This increase the pressure of the liquid medium is proportional to the applied force. The increase in pressure is measured by pressure gauge, which is connected to the liquid medium. Pressure is calibrated in force units, and hence the indication in the pressure gauge become measure of the force applied on the piston. Write only two paragraph. Write down first. When a force is applied on a liquid medium, when a force is applied on a liquid medium contain diaphragm, comma, the pressure of liquid increases. The pressure of liquid increases. Full stop. This increase in pressure of liquid is proportional to the applied force. Is proportional to the applied force. Stop. Hence, a measure of increase in pressure of the liquid becomes a measure of applied force, becomes a measure of applied force when calibrated. Full stop and next line. This increase in pressure of liquid medium is measured by pressure gauge which is connected to the liquid medium. Full stop. The pressure is calibrated in force unit and hence the indication in the pressure gauge becomes a major of the force applied on the piston. Of the force applied on the piston. This is all about hydraulic load cell. Next, pneumatic load cell. Pneumatic load cell. Do the heading pneumatic load cell and draw this diagram. Use the heading pneumatic load cell and draw this diagram. See the construction and working of pneumatic load cell. Here pressure regulator to supply the air. Here the flapper connected to applying force. Diaphragm is there. That air nozzle is there, and this air nozzle connected with U-tube manometer with field of mercury. When you supplying the air with the help of pressure regulator, this air passes the diaphragm and the diaphragm get vibrated. This vibration then apply force on this flapper. This vibration get minimized or stopped with the help of air nozzle, but here manometer displays some reading. So you have to compare before supplying air and after supplying air manometer reading. Okay, see the if a force is applied to the one side of the diaphragm and the air pressure is applied to the other side, some particular value of pressure will be necessary to exactly balance the force. This pressure is proportional to the applied force. Means here you have to air supply with the help of pressure regulator. This air supply passes here and diaphragm get vibrated. Still this vibration get removed or stopped. You have to add or apply force on this flapper and balance this air supply and force. Means air supply is directly proportional to the applied force. Application of force causes the flapper to come closer to the nozzle and the diaphragm to deflect downwards. The nozzle opening is nearly shut off and this result into an increased back pressure in the system. Okay. If nozzle wall is closed with the help of this flapper, this back pressure is created and this back pressure act on this manometer. The increased pressure act on the diaphragm produces an effective upward force which tends to return the diaphragm to its preload position. Okay. For any constant applied force, the system attains equilibrium. System attains equilibrium means this air supply and this force is same or equal. This diaphragm do not get vibrated, means system gets equilibrium. For any constant applied force, the system attains equilibrium at a specific nozzle opening and the corresponding pressure is indicated by the height of mercury column in a manometer. Since the maximum pressure in the system is limited to the air supply pressure, the range of unit can be extended only by using the large diameter diaphragm. Okay. So write down 3 to 4 points. First, if a force is applied to one side of a diaphragm, and air pressure is applied to the other side, comma, some particular value of pressure will be necessary to exactly balance the force. Full stop. This pressure is proportional to the applied force. This pressure is proportional to the applied force. Stop and explain. Application of force causes the flapper टू कम क्लोजर टू द डोजर एंड द डायफ्राम टू डिफ्लेक्स डाउनवर्ड, डायफ्राम डिफ्लेक्स डाउनवर्ड। स्टॉप, नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। द नोजल ओपनिंग इज नियरली शट ऑफ एंड दिस रिजल्ट इनटू एंड इंक्रीज द बैक प्रेशर इन द सिस्टम। स्टॉप। द इंक्रीज द प्रेशर एक्ट ऑन द डायफ्राम, द इंक्रीज द प्रेशर एक्ट ऑन द डायफ्राम produces an effective upward force, produces an effective upward force which tends to return the diaphragm to its preload position. Return the diaphragm to its preload position. Full stop and next. For any constant applied force,